Hi, here we are in Pixlr editor, and I'm going to show you a little bit more advanced editing today. Before, I've showed you how to do simple basic editing in Pixlr X. Today I'm going to show you how to do a little bit more advanced editing in Pixlr E, which is Pixlr editor. So I'm going to click here, and you can see you can get here directly by going to pixlr.com/e/. And it's going to be very similar to opening up an image in Pixlr X. So you'll just go to open image, and you'll be able to pull up all kinds of images. Wherever you got them from last time. And I'm going to go here, and I'm going to open up this largest file. I could tell it to not ask me to do this again, but I've been leaving it so that when I make a video, I can show you how this works, and hit apply. So I clicked, and it takes a while. Because I am using that largest file format, it takes it a little bit of time to actually open. And it should happen any moment now. Maybe I didn't. Okay, definitely clicked it that time. It can take a little bit of time when I choose those large files. There we are. I think I have failed to click it before. So the first thing I would do if I didn't have it shot in black and white is I would go to adjustment and desaturate. And then I'm going to show you how to do an adjustment in levels first, because it shows us this histogram that we talked about in the lecture. And so here is a good histogram. This is what we want histograms to look like. There's a lot of variations, but how those highlights, those highest tones here, so remember these are our dark tones. It also shows us down here. And these are our high tones up here, and this is how many pixels there are of them each. And so we don't want any that are, you know, bunched up here. We don't want this to, you know, kind of start really high here. We don't want any to be like bunched up over here. I'll show you some examples in a little bit. But this is an excellent histogram, a well-exposed image. And what we would be doing if it were not quite right, we just kind of pull our blacks over, kind of tighten them up here. Our whites get pulled over. Doesn't really have a chance. It's all the way over. And then I'm also going to move this. You can see what happens with the image at the same time. And then I would take this middle, and I would adjust it one way or the other to kind of increase my variety of those middle grays. So you can see what happens if I go one way, it kind of makes them more the same, kind of lighter. And if I go the other way, I can get a little bit more variation. So this is the kind of thing that I would be looking for. And this is pretty good. I'm going to hit apply. So not a bad thing. Let me see. I'm going to file and save this. I want to see if I will be able to, this is levels edited, and I'm going to download it. I've got my JPEG, my high quality, and I will download that. Yep, I'm going to save. It saves into my default download file. And then I'm going to get rid of the ad because this is the free version. And then down here in history, I want to show you a neat little trick. So I want to go back and edit this with curves instead of levels. And so what I'm going to do is, this is what I just did in my history here. I opened it, I desaturated, I went to levels. I'm going to go back to desaturate, and it undoes what levels did. You can see I didn't really do a lot to it. This is a fairly nice looking image without much adjustment. But let's see if we can improve on it by going to curves. So curves also uses the idea of the histogram. Pixlr E used to give you the option to turn on the histogram, and you could see it here. It does not allow that anymore, but we still have the same idea. These are our low tones, our blacks are down here, our whites or highlights are on this side, and we can double click to add what are called control points. And then with these control points, we can move them down to make things darker. You can already see how that's working. We can move them up to make things brighter, and it'll affect the tonal values that would reside in this area. And you can see that I've just increased the overall contrast of my image while I did that. And this is a typical kind of a thing that we want to look for, is just a nice gentle curve. If we start to add too many points in between, let's see if I can do something radical. Bring this up, bring this down. We can do these things, but sometimes it will start to make the image look a little strange. This one is doing okay. But in general, I'm just double clicking to get rid of them. I'm going to tell you just to stick to two control points and work on just kind of watching. So like here, I actually have some whites that are a little brighter than I would want them to be. So I might just kind of pull that down a little bit. And my whites are pretty good. My blacks are pretty good. If I wanted to kind of create more of a change in the middle, more of the middle tones, I would actually kind of do this sort of thing, and I would have to be careful what's going on here. But bringing these more to the center will create those kinds of changes in those middle grays more. I would have to watch to be careful. If I do something like this, I've just clipped my highlights, and that's something I don't want to do, because then I've lost all detail there. So generally speaking, I will keep this control point closer to here so that it controls that. And the same goes for this, because I could also, if I played with it, clip my blacks, and you can see I lose all my detail there. And I don't really want to do that either. So this is how curves work and how you want to kind of watch what's happening. And I can then apply. And you can see I got a little bit more contrast out of this image carefully, because this was already fairly contrasty to start with. So the other thing I wanted to show you was how to, I'm going to open some images. If it will let me go back to my images that I already have. Oh, nope, it's not letting me do that. All right, we'll just do it this way. So I'm going to show you what a histogram looks like. Find a couple of clipped histograms for you, because I can show them to you in here. Here we go. I don't have a lot that are, I'm going to just leave it at this full HD to help it load faster. But I don't have a lot of histograms that are not the way we want to see them. I should have shot things intentionally overexposed and underexposed. I'm just going to desaturate, and I'm going to show you with levels. Here is that clipped highlights, and you can see that our whites have lost detail, And that's something that when we have shot in JPEG particularly, we cannot go back. No matter what I do with this, I can make it look better by sliding this and bringing a little bit more dark tones to the image. But no matter what I do here, even if I pulled this in, I'm not going to get detail. It's just not going to happen. Just not. Okay, so I'm going to cancel that. And then I'm going to open an image that has, see if I can find clip shadows. This is probably as dark as it gets. Again, we'll open it up here. And it takes a moment. And adjustment desaturate. And then adjustment levels. So here you can see not quite clipped shadows. But you can see that I have very few highlights. And I can try to kind of pull this over here. But if I want to kind of bring some more variety, I'm still having trouble. This is where levels is not going to necessarily help me out a whole lot. It's kind of a little frustrating. So I'm going to cancel this, and I'll show you how curves can be more helpful in this kind of situation. So sometimes if I've got good strong blacks, I just want to brighten it up a little and not lose too much contrast. I could also add another here and hold my blacks down. But you can see that I can brighten up more of those highlights. I'd want to be careful not to go too far. Clip those highlights. Don't want to do that. But this is an example of how I could use curves to help me if I have underexposed my image a bit. And you can see how this kind of works together. As I move one, the other side kind of flexes. And I want to be careful not to let those things pop over that line. But this gives me, I've got whites that have some detail in it. So this is how curves and levels work in Pixlr E. I hope this has been helpful. I want to remind you that when we are editing, we are looking for the blacks with details, white with details, which is why we're concerned about not clipping our shadows or our highlights. As usual, if you have any questions, you know how to get in touch with me, and I look forward to seeing how you use this new information. Bye.